Cutting up gang, cutting up gang, man. Look, we going through this whole book. You feel me? Cutting up gang. Now at the end of each chapter, we're gonna go over the questions, about 60 to 80 questions in each chapter. You feel me? And we gonna do them.
First 48.
Boy, been killing all of them haircuts. Back to back, 30 minutes appointment time. You see me standing, top off. You see me winning. Everything better with a KP twin.
As a barber, you will spend most of your time in a standing position, raising your arms to work at the top of the client's head or bending over at the shampoo bowl are repetitive motions that can create physical stress in the hand, wrist, arm, shoulder, and lower back areas. When such stresses occur, physical or movement therapies may be required to maintain proper body alignment. So when you're working behind the chair, it's important to maintain a stress-free standing posture. Here are some guidelines that you should follow. Keep your head up and chin parallel to the floor. Keep your neck elongated and balanced directly above the shoulders. Lift your upper body so that your chest is up and don't slouch. Hold your shoulders level and relax. Stand with your spine straight. Just as there is a correct posture for standing, there is also a correct posture for sitting. Use the following guidelines to learn to sit correctly in a balanced position. Keep your hips level and horizontal, not tilted forward or backward. Flex your knees slightly and position them over your feet. Lower your body smoothly into a chair, keeping your back straight. Keep the soles of your feet on the floor directly under your knees. Have the seat of the chair even with your knees. This position will allow the upper and lower legs to form a 90-degree angle at the knees. Rest the weight of your torso on the thigh bones, not on the end of the spine. Keep your torso erect. Your muscles and bones work together as a musculoskeletal system, allowing you to walk, raise your arms, and use your fingers. Ergonomics is the science of designing the workplace, equipment, and tools to make specific body movements more comfortable, efficient, and safe. For example, a hydraulic chair can be raised or lowered to accommodate barbers of different heights, allowing each barber to serve his clients without bending over too far. Certain shears are designed to eliminate hand fatigue when cutting hair because repetitive movements are of particular concern. Barbers may have to stand or sit all day and perform repetitive movements, which makes them susceptible to problems of the hands, wrists, shoulders, neck, back, feet, and legs. Prevention is the key to avoiding problems. An awareness of your posture and movements, coupled with good work habits, proper tools, and equipment, will enhance your health and comfort. Repetitive motions have a cumulative effect on the muscles and joints. To avoid problems and work more effectively, follow these suggestions. Do not grip or squeeze tools and implements too tightly. Do not bend the wrist up or down constantly when cutting hair or using a blow dryer. Try to position your arms at less than a 6-degree angle when holding your arms away from your body while working. Avoid bending forward and slash or twisting your body to get closer to your client. Adjust the height of the chair so that the client's head is at a comfortable working level. Tilt the client's head as necessary for better access during hair services. To avoid ergonomic-related injuries, consider these further guidelines. Keep your wrists in a straight or neutral position as much as possible. Use ergonomically designed implements. Keep your back and neck straight. Stand on an anti-fatigue mat. When standing to cut hair, position your legs hip-width apart, bend your knees slightly, and align your pelvic area with your abdomen. Counter the negative impact of repetitive motions or long periods spent in one position by stretching and walking around at intervals. Always put your well-being first. To help relieve stress from repetitive movements or from standing or sitting in one position for too long, try these quick exercises. For wrists, stand up straight. Raise both of your arms straight out. Bend your wrists so your fingers point upward and hold for 5 seconds. Hold your wrists steady and turn your hands so your fingers face the floor and hold for 5 seconds. Repeat the cycle 5 times. For fingers, get a ball the size of a tennis ball or a tension ball. Grip it tightly for a count of 5. Release. Repeat 5 times. For shoulders, stand straight and shrug your shoulders upward. Roll your shoulders back and hold for a count of 5. Reverse direction and roll your shoulders forward for a count of 5. Repeat 5 times. Remember, prevention is key to avoiding problems related to ergonomic stress. Be mindful of your posture and movements. Use proper tools and equipment and take breaks to stretch and move around at regular intervals. Your well-being should always come first. In the early years of medical practice, barbers were more than just men who cut hair. They were also known as barber surgeons, and they had a wide range of duties that included hair cutting, beard trimming, tooth extraction, wound treatment, and even bloodletting. The history of the barber pole dates back to this time and is closely tied to the practice of bloodletting. Bloodletting was a common medical practice in those days, and it was often performed by barbers. To perform the procedure, a patient would have to grip a staff tightly so that the veins in their arm would stand out. The barbers would then make an incision and drain blood from the patient's veins. The staff, as it turned out, was an important tool during the procedure, which later evolved into the symbol of the barber pole. The barber pole is a long, cylindrical post that has white, red, and blue stripes wrapped around it. The bottom end cap of modern barber poles represents the basin that was used as a vessel to catch the blood during bloodletting. The white stripes on the pole stand for the bandages that were used to stop the bleeding and were hung on the staff to dry. The stained bandages would then twist around the pole in the breeze, forming a red and white pattern. One interpretation of the colors of the barber pole is that red represented the blood, blue the veins, and white the bandages. As time passed, the profession of barbering began to separate from religion and medicine, emerging as an independent profession. During the late 1800s, the profession structure changed and it began to take new directions. The formation of employer organizations known as master barber groups and employee organizations known as journeyman barber groups was the first step toward upgrading and regulating the profession. During this era, the emergence and growth of these organizations helped establish precedents and standards that are part of today's barbering profession. For example, the Barbers Protective Association was organized in 1896, and in 1897, it became the Barbermen Barbers International Union of America at its first convention in Buffalo, New York. By 1963, the name had changed again to the Journeyman Barbers, Hairdressers, Cosmetologists, and Proprietors International Union of America. In 1897, the first barber licensing law was passed in Minnesota, which set standards for sanitation, minimum education, and licensing requirements for barbers and barbershops. Similar laws were soon passed in other states to protect the public from infectious conditions. It was common at the time for towels, shaving brushes, and other barbering tools to be used on more than one customer without being disinfected in between, which provided ample opportunity for bacteria, parasites like Haemophilus, and infections like ringworm and herpes to be spread from one person to another, casting a bad light on barbers and barbershops in general. In 1916, the terminal method system was enacted in New York City, which outlined strict disinfection and cleaning practices for barbershops, beauty shops, and other small business enterprises at the main railway terminals in larger cities. The system soon spread to other shops throughout New York, providing customers with superior sanitary service. The Associated Master Barbers of America was established in Chicago, Illinois in 1924, eventually expanding to include beauty salon owners and managers and changing its name to the Associated Master Barbers and Beauticians of America in 1941. By 1925, its members had established the National Educational Council with the goal of standardizing and upgrading barber training. The council successfully set down the requirements of barber schools and barber instructor training, established a curriculum for barber schools, and recommended textbooks for barber instruction. The Associated Master Barbers of America also worked to increase public awareness of the role of barbers and beauticians in society and to improve the economic status of its members. In the mid-20th century, the Associated Master Barbers of America played a significant role in the civil rights movement. The organization worked to eliminate racial discrimination in the barbering and beauty industries and actively supported the efforts of African American barbers and beauticians to establish businesses and gain economic independence. The Associated Master Barbers of America also helped to create job opportunities for African Americans by establishing placement bureaus in major cities. Today, the Associated Master Barbers and Beauticians of America continues to play a vital role in promoting the interests of its members and advancing the standards of the barbering and beauty industries. For nearly a century, the Associated Master Barbers of America has been committed to providing training, education, and certification programs, as well as networking opportunities and other resources to help its members succeed in their businesses. By staying up to date on the latest trends and techniques in the field, the Associated Master Barbers of America members are able to provide their clients with the highest level of service. The Associated Master Barbers of America understands the critical importance of personal grooming and hygiene, especially in today's world where health and well-being are more important than ever. The organization is dedicated to promoting the idea that barbers and beauticians play a significant role in their clients' overall health and well-being. Through educational outreach and awareness campaigns, the Associated Master Barbers of America seeks to raise awareness of the importance of personal grooming and hygiene and to empower barbers and beauticians to serve as advocates for their clients' health. The Associated Master Barbers of America is much more than just an organization for barbers and beauticians. It's a community of professionals who are dedicated to their craft and committed to promoting the high standards of professionalism and excellence in the industry. So if you're a barber, beautician, or just someone who's interested in the world of personal grooming and hygiene, we encourage you to join the Associated Master Barbers of America today and become part of a vibrant and supportive community that's dedicated to helping you succeed. Don't forget to like and comment on our video and subscribe to our channel to stay up to date on barber content.
Okay, cutting up, guys.